people. Destroy the works of the devil.
Amen.
And let your name be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Let's be seated. In the book of 2 Kings, chapter 5, I read from verse 1 downward a little. Now, Naaman, captain of the host of the king of Syria, was a great man with his master and honorable, because by him the Lord had given deliverance unto Syria. He was also a mighty man in valor, but he was a leper. The topic we want to consider this morning is what I call the spiritual leprosy. We want to deal with this terrible ailment in the spiritual or in the spirit realm before we finally come to the physical. John, the forerunner of the Lord Jesus Christ, said something in the book of John, chapter 3, verse 27. He said, man can receive nothing except that thing is being given to him from above. Man can receive nothing except it be given him from heaven. In other words, anything that will happen in the physical must first of all happen in the spiritual. If a man is going to be blessed here on earth, in the spirit realm, he must have been blessed. If somebody is going to be turned mad, becoming a lunatic, in the spirit realm, they would have called him to witchcraft coven, or marine witchcraft coven, or in an occultic kingdom. He will not go there physically. He will go in the spirit. They will call the person. He will appear in the spirit realm. They will either hit him with demonic hammer or anything. Then he woke up. He will begin to act as a mad person. It has happened in the spirit realm. There are so many people who wanted to travel. They got their international passport and they were really not planning for it. Suddenly, they slept up, had a dream, and they will see a hand that will strengthen them, and they will give the international passport to the hand. In the physical, the international passport is still where he kept it. But in the spiritual, it has been taken away. He will get to embassy. They will not give him or her the visa, because already it has been stolen away in the spirit realm. I pray for you today that all the spiritual armed robbers that had ever robbed you in your dream, what they have taken away will be restored this morning in the name of Jesus. Some people, they will sleep. They are pregnant and they will see something red, either red cloth, or some will see blood, or some will see red flag. And when they wake up, behold, it has spoiled. It has happened in the spirit realm before the manifestation in the physical. I pray for all of you that had ever got pregnant and that had such a dream, and you woke up, behold, blood. I decree that from today onward, it will never happen to you again in the name of Jesus. Some women in their dream, they will see their baby. Somebody will just come and snatch the baby from them. They will be struggling to get the baby in the dream. They will not get the baby until they wake up. Sooner or later, the child will fall sick and later die. It has been taken away in the spirit realm. If you have ever had such a dream, and eventually the child died, I decree that from today onward, that such a dream will never come to manifestation any longer in your life in the name of Jesus. Spiritual leprosy, the topic. This man in the book of 2 Kings chapter 5 was a great man of valor. He was so great to the point that the king, the president, where he was the chief of staff, supreme headquarters, loved him so much. Loved him so much. The Bible says, through him, the Lord had given deliverance unto Syria. He was also a mighty man in valor, but he was a leper. Leprosy is a disease. You ought to be praying that your house or your household will never experience in life. Leprosy is a terminal disease. Leprosy is a terrible disease that can be transferred. Leprosy is a disease that causes shame in people's life. In fact, everyone on the planet Earth ought to be praying that they will not experience leprosy. Leprosy is so terrible to the point that God himself do not take leprosy matter as simple. He take it so serious. Even in the Bible, in the book of Leviticus chapter 13. Leviticus chapter 13. I want to read from verse 1. And the Lord spoke unto Moses and Aaron, saying, when a man shall have in the skin of his flesh a rising, a scab, a bright spot, and it be in the skin of his flesh like the plague of leprosy, then he shall be brought unto Aaron the priest, or unto one of his sons the priest. And the priest shall look on the plague in the skin of the flesh. And when the hair in the plague is turned white, and the plague inside be deeper than the skin of his flesh, it is a plague of leprosy. Do you read it in your own Bible that God did not call it a sickness? He didn't call it a disease. But he said, leprosy is a plague. A plague of leprosy. And the priest shall look on him and pronounce him unclean. That is as terrible as the situation of leprosy is. If somebody is HIV positive, he can sit among his people. He can eat with them. He can play with them. Even if the infirmity has gone worse, he can still sit down, talk with them, eat with them, do everything with them. But in the case of leprosy, when somebody is plagued with leprosy, that such a person will not be able to sit among his people again. The Bible says, where we read, if you get home, go and read it all. That after the priest has examined the person, and such a person is plagued with real leprosy, the Bible says they should take him into a bush. Look for something like a hut. Build it for the such a person. Whoever he might have been in the past, he will now be living alone in a bush. And nobody should eat with him. Nobody should drink with the cup he drank with. Nobody should eat with the plate he ate with. He will stay there all alone. That is as terrible as leprosy is. And when leprosy comes upon anyone, what leprosy will do is terrible. Leprosy will take away man's glory. Leprosy will take away man's dignity. Leprosy will take away man's honor. Leprosy will take away man's love. If a man is plagued with leprosy, the wife will not be able to act with him, love him the way he used to be. If a woman is plagued with leprosy, the interaction between the woman and the man before, there will be separation. In fact, if the wife or the husband says, I love my husband, I love my wife, I want to get closer, people will call her. Do you love your children? I don't say that you don't love your husband. I don't say that you don't love your wife. But do you love your children? Say yes. If you love your children, don't go to this man, because don't go closer to this woman, because it can be transferred. That is how terrible leprosy is. That is the physical leprosy. Now, I want to go to the spiritual leprosy. What is the spiritual leprosy? The spiritual leprosy is sin. That is the spiritual leprosy. And I want to say this, that sin is more terrible, more horrible, more tougher than the physical leprosy. We take sin as very light. We don't count sin to be anything. We think sin is nothing. But sin is so terrible that it destroys man's life. Sin is as ugly as the devil himself. In the book of 1 John chapter 3 verse 8, the Bible says, he that is committing sin is of the devil. Whoever the person may be, on the altar or in the congregation, he that is committing sin is of the devil. In the time of David was a king. And God loved him. It got a time, problem came upon David. And David was in a condition that was so terrible, to the point that people were running away from him. Even his only begotten son Absalom wanted to take away his kingship from him. One of his friends went to him and he began to talk to him. David, I know you love God. I know you have done so much for God. Why is it that with all you are passing through, God is looking at you like this? You have prayed. I know you are a man of prayer. You prayed and prayed and prayed. Why is it that God did not answer your prayers? David said, I beg, make you no add to my trouble.
Don't add to my problem.
The man said, why? Let's see the answer. In the book of Psalm 119, I read verse 67.
The man said, before I was afflicted, I went astray. Before I was afflicted, I committed a terrible sin.
Now look up here.
If I want to ask you a question now and say, my brother, my sister, I want you to make mention of one of the terrible sins.
Oh, you say, if somebody commit adultery, it's terrible.
Yes, another one.
If somebody murdered a person, it's another terrible sin.
Yes, another one.
You begin to make mention of big, the one we think are big sin. But brethren, let me tell you the truth. Sin is sin.
Small, very small liquid of poison can kill.
Do you know that?
Very small. Very small. As much liquid a poison can kill, so also very small liquid of poison kills.
Abraham, what are you talking about? This is what I'm talking about.
A liar and the person that loves a liar,
he is not a liar now. He just loved a liar.
Somebody's telling lies, and you know it, and you laugh. I say, I love you. Your mouth is sweet.
You have committed sin.
As horrible as adultery and fornication is, so also lying
is the same sin.
A murderer and a disobedient person and an angry man or woman, they are the same. Sin, no matter how minute it may be, when it comes to your life, it comes to destroy your life. Oh, pastor, I was in manifest social year. I was in this program, Divine Encounter, social time. And our daddy, the vicar, in the Divine Encounter, our daddy, the bishop, in the manifest social year, prophesied. He even called me out and said, my daughter, my son, you are blessed. The Lord said, between now and this social time, you are going to receive social time. And I shouted amen. In fact, I even came to the church. I donated a huge amount because of that prophecy. But pastor, all through that year, nothing happened.
Oh, I want to ask a question. Is God telling lies?
Then why? It did not happen. If God is not telling lies,
let's see the cause.
In the book of Jeremiah.
I pray for somebody here today that in the name of Jesus, before you leave this place, miracle. I said miracle will happen in your life. And in the mighty name of Jesus, you will give glory to God's name.
In the book of Jeremiah chapter 5 verse 25. Oh, bishop prophesied, vicar prophesied, canon prophesied, and reverend prophesied. They did not come to pass. Why? I even had a dream. I saw an old man in my dream wore a white apparel. The man said, by this other time, so good thing will happen to me. Sir, it did not happen.
What caused it? 5:25. Your iniquities have turned away these things, and your sin have withholding good things from you.
Is it in your Bible?
Make una talk now. You will be surprised that when Abraham Yakubu come, he used not to speak things that will make us laugh. Why? I not go make you laugh when I know the truth. How will I come to make you laugh when actually there is nothing to laugh about? Do you understand? Why should I be deceiving you? Daddy, how can I make them laugh when I know that he that is committing sin is of the devil? When I know that God answered not a sinner? When I know that you have been praying to God and your prayers are not answered because your iniquities have turned away these things and your sin of withholding good things from you? I know it. Why should I be deceiving you? Why? Why? So many people all over the world, they used to accuse God. Oh God, you are the one who said we should pray. I prayed. I fasted with different kind of fasting. White fasting. Daddy, oil fasting. Which one is white? The one you eat without oil, peppery, sugary, salt. No salt, no oil, no pepper. They say I should be taking fruit for 30 days. Daddy, I did it. Nothing happened. Nothing to show for it. I can see that this God is partial. Why is it that I've been praying? He did not answer my own prayer. You are not the first person to say that. Even the children of Israel, they accuse God. They call God. And right in the presence of God, they pointed to his nose and accused him. Let's see how they accused God. In the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 58. When they began to accuse God, that is why God sent his servant to go and talk to them. Isaiah chapter 58, verse 1. God sent a servant, he said, cry aloud, spare not, lift up thy voice like a trumpet, and show my people their transgression, and the house of Jacob, they are what? They are sin. Yet, they seek me daily. Early in the morning prayer, they are there. In their houses, they have altar of prayer. They have bell. They ring every morning. It's very good. Yet, they seek me daily. Look at what follows. And delight to know my ways. And that is why you are here. As a nation that did righteousness and forsake not the ordinances of their God, they ask of me the ordinances of justice. They take delight in approaching God. You also take delight in approaching God. And they begin to challenge God in verse 3. Wherefore have we fasted? Now you say, make your prophet tell us to fast. We fasted. Wherefore have we fasted? Say they, and thou seest not. Wherefore have we afflicted our soul? We fasted white fasting, red fasting, all round fasting. We afflicted our soul, and you see it not. Now, the answer. Isaiah 59 from verse 1. If you have not slept like a woman far away and the one very close to me now, if you are not sleeping like them, shout a big hallelujah! Thank you for waking them up. Isaiah chapter 59, I read from verse 1. Behold, the Lord is answering them now. He's answering the question. Behold, the Lord's hand is not shorting, that it cannot save, neither his ear heavy, that it cannot hear. But your iniquities has separated between you and your God, and your sin have hid his face from you, that he will not hear. Now listen to this. When we were in the primary school, I believe you have been like my own before. When we used to carry slate, not this time that they are carrying computer, not slate with the carry those days. When we carry slate to school with chalk, white chalk, had it ever happened to you? Now listen. There is what they call present tense, past tense, and past participle. God is saying here, he said, but your iniquities have separated between you and your God. That is past. And your sin have hide away his face from you. That is past and now. That he will not. That one has not happened. He will not hear. In the past, sin has made it. Sin is the cause. Why you prayed, he did not answer. Now, you are still praying. That sin is still there. It makes him not to answer. And if you allow that horrible spiritual leprosy that is called sin to remain in your life, you will still pray and he will not hear. You know, Daddy, I love God for something. He will not deceive you. He will tell you the truth to hold her. That is God for you. Man can deceive. Man can love with you. Man can joke. Man can. But as for God, God will not deceive you, Mama. He will not. He will not. God will not rub your head. One day I was preaching. I think in Osun State, I preached on worldliness. God said, go and tell them what you see in the hall of worldliness. I preached that worldliness. It was not as supposed. When I got to my guest house, I was praying. I heard the voice of the Lord crying. I said, Daddy, why are you crying? He said, Abraham, are you tired? After all, you were a dead person before. If you are tired, let me kill you, take you home, and send another person to go and preach worldliness as it is. So that he will preach what he saw. And I said, God, why? He said, listen to me. Go back tomorrow. Tell them everything you saw in the hall of worldliness. I said, I'm sorry. He said, before you say sorry, not now, tomorrow. Tomorrow. Let me see the sorry tomorrow in the message you are going to preach. And Daddy, when I got to the altar, it was as if something else has happened. When I was preaching, people were removing all those things that the devil used to beautify their faces. They were removing it right there, crying like baby. And when I got back to the guest house and I knelt down praying, and the Lord said, my son, well done. That is why I will not deceive you. In the book of John, Jesus opened the eyes of a blind. When this man was over 40 years of age, when he came into the temple and Jesus was moving out, he saw the man in a place and he said, you are the one that is healed from today. Go and sin no more. So that the worst thing that is more than the one that happened to you, that made you to be blind for over 40 years, will not happen to you again. And what is that worst thing? If he continue in sin, he will die and end up in hell. That's the meaning. But when people saw this man and they were telling him, we want you to say, Jesus is not the one that healed you. Jesus is a sinner. Jesus is this and that. The man said, whether he's a sinner or not, I know not. But one thing I know, I was blind, but now I have received my sight. And he said, for we know that God answered not a sinner. Oh, it is my will that your prayers will be answered today. And I know this wonderful man of God sitting down here, it is his heart desire that your prayers will be answered. And do you know something? It is God's wish that when you cry to him in the day of trouble, it is his will to deliver you. But God will not deliver if sin is there and you don't do away with it. Hello? Hello? There was a time the children of Israel were murmuring. They murmur. We come to church. They say we should pay tithe. We pay our tithe. They say we should build a house. We build it. They say they are going to have another branch. I know how much I donated. I've been praying. God did not answer my prayer. Then the voice of God came to his prophet Jeremiah in the book of Lamentation. Lamentation chapter 3. Verse 39. Wherefore doth a living man complain? Why are you complaining? The punishment that comes to you, Lamentation said, a man for the punishment of his, what is it? Don't complain. Why are you complaining? Why are you saying, I pray God did not answer? God answered prayers. So why is a living man complaining? Let everybody complain because of the sin he committed. Brethren, let me explain to you, as you are going to pray, what sin is. One, sin is horrible. Sin is ugly. Sin is evil. In fact, sin is more terrible than evil. Sin is a stigma. Sin is more dirty than the most dirtiness. Sin is worse than physical leprosy. Sin is more horrible than HIV/AIDS. Sin is deadly. Sin is destructive. Sin is contamination. Sin do remove crown from king's head. Sin removes crown from king's head. Sin takes away mighty men's glory. Mighty men, mighty women's glory. Sin will take it away. Sin shuts up authoritative mouth. A man that when he's talking, Baba, everybody will keep quiet. If he's found having adultery with another man's wife, and they caught him right-handed when he was in the act, and they brought him to the community, an authoritative mouth, you do it, I beg, I'm sorry, make una forgive me, an authoritative mouth. That is how terrible sin is. Hey, sin removes garment of honor from noblemen. Sin. Sin dumps the men of glory into the wall of perpetual terrible feet. Sin. Sin. Don't joke with sin. No. Don't play with sin. Don't play with sin. Sin is more than dreadful nightmare. Sin is more strong than the iron chain with hook. When it hook a man, you will want to be, you come out of it, no way. You can use one finger to invite sin. You can not use your 10 finger to push sin out of your life. I'm telling you the truth. That is how terrible sin is. Sin is a reproach to any nation. Sin's wages is death. Sin will land you in hell. Don't joke with sin. Don't joke with sin. Don't joke with sin. What is the way out? Genuine repentance. Everybody look at me. I dress very neat. Put on white suit. And I'm passing through a place. And pile escalator came over me. Pile escalator. Jedi. And I'm on the road. Looking for a way to ease myself, no place. And eventually, in my body. Look up here. There are strangers I did not invite that will be following me. What is their name? Clap your hand for yourself now. Fly. I did not invite them, oh, they will be following. Okay. I say, fly. When they follow me, then I begin to pray. In the name of Jesus, Master, you fly. Go away. Go away. Go away. Will they go away? Make una talk now. As I see that I tried and prayed and prayed and they did not go, I say, okay, I no go pray again. Now curse, I go, they curse all of them. You fly. You are evil. You no go better for you. I say, make you go. You no go. Will they go away? Okay, she say, curse, no fit. Then I look for broom. Mama, I went to look for broom. Hold the broom. Both right hand and left. Go away. Go away. Fly. Una no de here. Una no de here. Una no de here. Will they go away? If I want them to go away, what will I do? Go into bedroom. Remove the trouser. Everything upon me. Take my bag. Now be so. Wash the pint. Wash everything. Put on another new one. Without speaking in tongues. Without the broom. Will they go or they will not go? Will they still be following me? Problems of life and demons. We never leave a person that is committing sin until he stop it. And there is no way of stopping it until the person come to the feet of Jesus to be washed by the blood. What can take away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Rise up on your feet. God is ready to answer your prayers. But you will have to do something first. Confess your sin. He that covereth a sin or her sin will not prosper. But he that confesseth and forsaketh shall have mercy. Lift up your two hands to God. Say, Lord Jesus. That is why that people should not sit down. There are people that are still sitting down. Anywhere you are, stand up. Say, Lord Jesus. I want to be blessed this morning.
I want to be blessed this morning.
Every sin in my life.
Every sin in my life
that will hinder my prayer not to be answered.
That will hinder my prayer not to be answered.
Use the blood of Jesus.
Use the blood of Jesus
to wash the sin away.
To wash the sins away.
From the bottom of your heart, begin to pray. If you love yourself, pray from the bottom of your heart. Wash yourself in the blood.